What a year it's been for you. World champion pole vaulter, and now you're preparing for your first Olympics. What's going through your head?
I'm just trying to stay healthy. I'm really trying to progress up the mountain and be an athlete like I haven't been before. There's a lot of steps I know I can still take to improve in my athletics, and now it's just trying to set out and do those things.
Obviously, it's your first Olympics, so on one hand, there isn't that much expectation because you've never competed on that stage, but on the other, you're the world champion. So there is expectation that comes with that. How do you channel those? Do you feel any pressure at all?
I think there is a lot more pressure this year, especially coming in and being the world champion and trying to do something that I haven't necessarily done before. I know at the Olympic Games, there's going to be a lot of the same competitors that were there at the World Championships. So the pressure is there to compete and to at least come away with a medal, I think. And that's the pressure that I'm putting on myself. But it's a completely different atmosphere at the Olympics. You know, there's a lot more at stake. It only comes around every 4 years or so. So it's not the same feeling as going to a World Championships, but I think that there's a lot of the same pressures there.
What are your expectations for the event in terms of how it's going to be? What are you expecting Rio to do for you?
When you look at the Olympics, you look at, maybe it's not the best competition as far as like athletes' technique, but you always see athletes jump completely out of their minds and do some incredible things, and that's just because there's so much amazing atmosphere and adrenaline in the air, and everybody's feeding off that to make them perform very well.
Born in 1994, this Canadian pole vaulter rose to fame at the World Championships in Beijing in 2015 when he captured gold. And as part of his prize, the young man was treated to a traditional Chinese breakfast, although some say it was more of a punishment because he had to eat it with me. Do you feel differently now since you won that gold medal?
I'm really just trying to take a lot of the momentum I have coming off of that gold in Beijing, and I'm trying to use that to help keep me going this year, going into Rio. And I know I was working on a lot of good things that year, and if I can continue some of those good aspects in my vault, I'll do quite well.
As the reigning Pan American champion, his winning height of 5.80 is joint tied for the Pan American all-time best, together with Lazario Borghe. For this 22-year-old, it's just the start. Of course, you're 22 years old now, and you can't live a normal 22-year-old life, right?
I don't think so. You know, when you wake up in a different time zone just about every week, it makes life a little bit more challenging. But luckily, I have a support staff with me and everything to make sure that everything goes as planned and I'm able to do my job very well.
An athlete's career in the grand scheme of things is very short.
Actually. Absolutely.
Have you thought about what you'd like to do when your pole vaulting days are over?
Well, I know that I'm very passionate about the world of track and field, and I'd like to stay in this world as much as I can. Time will tell. I think I have a good 9 more years in the sport at least, if I'm lucky. So I'll just have to wait and see, whatever my calling is.
How confident are you of getting a gold?
Well, I think that in the next 9 years or so, in the next decade of me jumping, I think I'll have some very good shots at gold. This year in Rio, I give myself a very good chance to be on the podium, and that's my goal this year, be on the podium somewhere. I give myself a chance at the gold. If you put yourself in the running and if you put yourself in that top 3 position, it all comes down to luck, I think, at the end of the day.